Hi there, Year 10. It's Mr. Betcher here. I am making this little quick video to try and explain to you how to create a graph using a spreadsheet. And the spreadsheet we're using in this instance is Microsoft Excel, but this would in fact work pretty much the same way for any spreadsheet, so Google Sheets or any other one you want to try and use. Spreadsheets just basically work the same everywhere. So this is some experimental data that someone has collected, and you can see it's two columns, time and temperature, and there are some numbers. And just so you understand where these numbers are coming from, what this experiment was about was taking a glass of liquid, let's say warm water, and a thermometer, and this is a chopstick, not a thermometer, but use your imagination, and putting the thermometer into the liquid and taking its temperature, and then waiting a little while and checking the temperature, and then waiting a little while and checking the temperature again. And what would happen over time, as I'm sure you could guess, is the temperature would cool down. Like having a hot cup of tea and just leaving it sit on the table, it would eventually get cold. So this experimental data is that experiment. It's taking a warm liquid and allowing it to cool down. So you can see that at 0 seconds into our experiment, so when we started, the temperature was 21.51 degrees Celsius. And then 25 seconds later, it was 15.39 degrees Celsius. And then 50 seconds later, it was 11.47, and so on. So you can see from looking at this that the temperature is being taken every 25 seconds. And as the time goes forward in 25 second blocks, the temperature we check changes. It drops every time we take the new temperature. And in science terms, this is what's called, the time is what's called an independent variable. In other words, we really can't control time. We can't fast forward it. We can't rewind it. It just goes along at its own pace. It's independent of anything we might want to do to it. Temperature, on the other hand, is dependent. So as time goes forward, the temperature changes. So the temperature depends on the time. So that's where those two ideas come from, independent and dependent. So how do we take this experimental data and now turn it into a graph so we can see what it looks like? Well, in Excel, the simple way to do that is you select it with your mouse. So I've clicked on the first cell there, which is the one with time, seconds in it, and selected all the way down to the final number in the temperature column. And once you've done that, from the insert menu, you have a whole bunch of buttons up here to let you insert different types of charts. Now, here's the trick with creating a graph. You have to use the correct chart type for the data you've got. If you use a chart type that's not really the right type, you'll get a result that doesn't make any sense at all. I'll give you an example of that. This would make no sense as a pie chart. But if I choose pie chart, you see I do in fact get a pie chart. It just doesn't mean anything. All these numbers, to look at this chart, it's not telling you anything at all. So it's not that it's bad data, it's the wrong graph. So let's get rid of that by pressing delete. A better way to do this would be to simply take the points at which we're testing the temperature and plot the points and then join them up with a line. Now, that type of graph is what's known as a scatter graph or a scatter chart. So when you insert a scatter chart, what it will do is it will plot the points that you've mapped using your data. But we actually want to join them with a line. So you could choose this next option here, which is to plot the points and join them with a line. So let's pick that. And you can see, lo and behold, there is the graph that we were after. And you can see, looking at it, along the bottom here, this is time moving forward. And this is temperature dropping. So as time goes forward, temperature drops. And that's the graph that explains the experiment that we did. Now, this is not quite complete as a chart, though. We're missing a few things. This bottom axis here, we know it represents time. But for someone who looks at this graph, we need to make that really clear for them. So we need to label it. Same, we need to label this one here, which is in fact the temperature. And up here it says temp degrees Celsius, which really doesn't make any sense as a title for the graph, so we need to change that. So let's look at how we do that. So once the chart is made, which was very simple, we selected the data and we chose scatter graph with a line. Once we've got it, go to the layout button up here, and you get a whole bunch of options for changing bits and pieces of the chart. So first of all, let's change the chart title. This is really all about liquid cooling. So let's call the graph liquid cooling. So I'm going to go to chart title. And right now I'm getting a chart. It's displaying above the chart. You could see I can say none and have no title. I could have a title that's overlaid over the top, or I could have a title that's above the chart. I think I like the above the chart. So I'll click in there, select it with my mouse, and I'll just type in liquid cooling down. Okay, that's, I don't know what you want to call this chart, that's what I'm going to call it chart. So the next thing we need to do is label the axis, and you can see I've got axis titles. Here's a button here for axis titles, so let's do that. So we'll go, now we've got the primary horizontal, that's the one this way, and I want the title below the axis, so I choose that, and look, there it is there. So I'm going to label this one, just select it with my mouse and type in time. That's perfect. And this one here is the vertical axis. So let's go in there and we will go axis titles, primary vertical axis. And what I'd like to do is to turn the word on its side. So that would be rotated title, like that. So we'll click in there and try and select that, like so. And I'm going to call this one temperature, if I can spell it right. Temperature. There you go. Enter. Oops, click away from there. And there is my finished chart. I have the actual graphed data. I have the axis labeled clearly. I have the other axis labeled clearly. I have a title, and I have a legend on the side here that tells me what this line is, which is temperature in degrees C. So I hope that makes sense.